Hippie Hippie Shake, a great song in one of the worst movies I've ever seen. Cocktail with Tom Cruise, one of the worst films I've ever seen
ever?
In my life, ever.
That's a pretty powerful
I hate
speech.
It. Say hi to Nick, St. Nick.
How are
He's
you
from
today?
SimpleBartender.com. And Nick, you probably say, I know that guy. He works at four different bars around the St. Louis area.
I do.
Probably mixed up a cocktail or two for you. And while you might be cracking a beer open on this 4th of July, how about you wow your guests with something like a bomb pop, or over here, something like a Java Nirvana. You're gonna show us how to do it, right, Nick?
I am, actually. So today we're gonna make two different cocktails. Like I said, the bomb pop, I figured it being 4th of July.
It's pretty.
Yeah, exactly. You know, it's a layered cocktail. So if you look down at the grenadine and the blue carousel and actually the cocktail itself, so it gives it a red, white, and blue.
So no James Bonding, no shaking or stirring.
So you are actually you're gonna make this cocktail.
Okay,
today.
Let's do it, put me to work.
So what we're gonna do here today is I have some sweet and sour, roughly about an ounce and a half of sweet and sour.
Okay.
So don't put
in
that
here, duh.
There.
I used to be a bartender a long
time
ago.
It'll be second nature to you then.
One of my favorite jobs I ever had, honestly.
That is raspberry vodka. This is triple sec.
Okay, triple sec. That's the stuff that goes in Rita's.
And then I forgot to get the ice. You need ice.
A bartender forgets the ice.
I know.
All right, Nick,
actually,
you're fired.
I forgot
you
the actual stuff. So I need you to put that in there.
You are fired.
And shake it up. So you're gonna put the lid on this one. So. I didn't bring any cocktails.
Hippie shake. Hate that movie. The worst. Cocktails the worst.
So today we're actually making a drink using a Starbucks mug and a glass.
That's fine. Whatever works, man.
Exactly. And I have a strainer here. So we're going to do this. So that's your base for the cocktail.
Okay.
Okay. And then what actually is going to go on here as far as on the grenadine and blue carousel is
so
that certain alcohols have different weights. They're called gravity. So sugar to alcohol volume ratio. So grenadine is going to be really heavy. There's not much
There's
alcohol.
There's science in cocktails?
There is. Sometimes a little bit here and there. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the grenadine. There's a layer on the side of the glass like that. It's going to pour just a little bit of amount.
Okay, I get it. It goes to the bottom.
And then blue carousel has a lot of sugar, but a little more alcohol. So it's going to be a little bit heavy, but not as heavy as the grenadine.
Oh, that's pretty.
It's easy and basic like that.
Okay, we got to get to the Java Nirvana because I
not
understand there are some fireworks involved.
There are some fireworks involved.
Okay.
So this Java Nirvana is actually made with a house brew coffee liqueur, a vanilla vodka, and a dark cream de coco, which is a chocolate liqueur as well. And so I already pre-shook that up because we don't really have any cocktail shakers. But what really gets this thing going here actually is
stepping away. You do it. I'm not doing it.
Flame roasted coffee. All right.
Wait, you're flame roasting the coffee.
I am flame roasting the coffee grounds. So a lot of what you taste in food and drinks is going to be having to do with as far as what you smell.
I like the way that smells.
Exactly. So when you get the coffee grounds all kind of roasted up and drizzled on top.
See, I'm one of those people, I don't mind a few coffee grounds in my coffee. It gives it a deeper, darker flavor. And I'm sure it's the same for our little Java Nirvana, right?
It's quite fantastic.
So on simplebartender.com, can we get recipes, demonstrations?
You can get recipes. That'll actually show you a link to the YouTube channel for demonstrations. I started all this I bartend a lot of places and I have to train a lot of people.
Right.
So I figured if I have a place where I can just tell bartenders, you know, this is how you make it. And you know, go on this website and look
That's
at
cool.
it. That way, so they constantly have a background for it.
There you go.
That.
If you want to wow your friends at the barbecue on this 4th of July, simplebartender.com is the place. And next time you see Nick in one of the four bars he works, tip him huge. He earned it, right? We'll be back with more on the 9 a.m.